Hoffman was shot in the arm by Iraqi troops September 5th and told his family after his release last Friday he may need a bone graft to repair the damage. Air Force doctors say he's in good condition. AM 750 WSB international relations expert Patrick O'Heffernan says the national debate over just what we're doing in the Gulf and why is only now getting underway.
I can't tell you why we have 150,000 men there and all that equipment. The first we were told that it was to defend Saudi Arabia. Saudi Arabia's been defended. Obviously, that's not a problem anymore.
O'Heffernan says Congress is beginning to raise questions, but we haven't yet heard comprehensively from the administration. He says we have an evolving Gulf policy, one that could evolve right into war. Stay tuned to AM 750 WSB for the latest news from the Middle East at the top of every hour, and we'll break in with updates. Japan officially enthroned its new emperor today, the first time that's happened since 1928, when Emperor Hirohito was considered a god. His son, 56-year-old Prince Akihito, became part of a tradition that dates back 2,600 years. But correspondent Vince Sherry reports many of his subjects don't care.
Despite threats of violence and unprecedented security, many Japanese treated today's enthronement ceremony as nothing more than a paid holiday. One poll indicated that nearly half of Japan had no interest in the enthronement. This was particularly true among young Japanese who have no recollection of the state-sponsored emperor worship that ended with World War II.
In his speech, the new emperor pledged to honor Japan's post-war constitution, which effectively keeps Japan from maintaining an offensive military capability. AM 750 WSB News Center time, 12:02. Just ahead, a new dancing ordinance for Marietta, plus the weather from Atlanta's only full-time radio meteorologist.
Haverty makes it home.
Tuesday from 4 till 10 p.m.
Haverty's Furniture gives you 6 solid hours of savings.
It's Haverty's 6-hour night sale, featuring 10 to 50% savings on every piece of quality furniture in all 12 metro area Haverty showrooms.
With no interest and no payments till March.
Every living room, sofa, loveseat, and recliner is on sale.
Every dining room, dinette, and occasional table is on sale.
Every bedroom is on sale. Everything in every department is reduced 10 to 50%.
With no interest and no payments till March.
Once again,
Haverty's makes it home.
Let me repeat, this Tuesday at Haverty, everything in every department is reduced 10 to 50%.
With no interest and no payments till March on purchases of $300 or more with approved credit.
Don't miss Haverty's 6-hour night sale.
Everything in every department is on sale.
Tuesday from 4 till 10 p.m. only.
And only at Haverty's.
That's right.
Haverty's makes it home.
News Center time, 12:04. Just in from a Bell South Mobility caller. If you're headed towards Atlanta on I-85 South around Spaghetti Junction, watch out. There's a stalled car at that location. In Savannah, the annual meeting of the Georgia Baptist Convention is underway. The top order of business, picking a new president. It's between a conservative, the Reverend William Harrell, pastor of Abilene Baptist Church in Martinez, and a moderate, Reverend J. Truett Gannon, pastor of Smoke Rise Baptist Church in Stone Mountain. Strange sex acts are on the agenda tonight at a work session of the Marietta City Council. They'll be talking about flagellation and necrophilia. And it doesn't stop there. Councilman Dana Eastham says the new ordinance about nude dancing has to be super selective.
I'd like to get something passed before the end of this year. If we wait too long, somebody could start some kind of a show that depicts acts that we do not want at all in the city of Marietta.
So it has to be specific. Eastham is also interested in discouraging adult bookstores in Marietta, but he doesn't see a need to ban what he calls mainstream publications like Playboy and Penthouse. On Wall Street, the Dow is up almost 29 points to 25.17 and a half. The time, 12:05. Here, triple the traffic coverage. The Bell South Mobility Network and Skycopter Skyplane reports. And when you see a problem, dial asterisk 750, a free call for Bell South Mobility customers. Now, Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
Saudi Arabia today, highs 85, lows 54. The WSB exclusive five-day forecast. Today, blue sky and warm with low humidity, high around 71. Clear and cool tonight, low 38 to 43. Sunshine tomorrow, a bit cooler, high near 66, low 35 to 42. And the extended forecast Wednesday through Friday, mainly sunny, high 65 to 71. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mullish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
Currently, WSB color radar is all clear. We have clear skies, relative humidity 47%. Winds from the northwest at 12, barometer 30.29 and steady. And at 12:06, the temperature on Peachtree Street, 64 degrees. WSB talk show host Ludlow Porch is next. I'm Bob Cox, and if news breaks out, we'll break in. This is Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
Kid, kid, I'd take a trip every summer down to Mississippi to visit my granny and her antebellum world. I'd run barefooted all day long, climbing trees free as a song. And one day I happened to catch myself a squirrel. Well, I stuffed him down in an old shoebox and punched a couple holes in the top. When Sunday came, I snuck him into church. I was sitting way back in the very last pew, showing him to my good buddy Hugh, when that squirrel got loose and went totally berserk. But what happened next is hard to tell. Some thought it was heaven, others thought it was hell. But the fact that something was among us was plain to see. As the choir sang, I surrender all, the squirrel ran up Harv Newland's coveralls. And Harv leaped to his feet and said, something's got a hold on me. Yow! The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, hallelujah. Well, Harv hit the aisles dancing and screaming. Some thought he had religion, others thought he had a demon. And Harv thought he had a weed eater loose in his fruit of the looms. He fell to his knees to plead and beg, and the squirrel ran out of his britches leg unobserved to the other side of the room. All the way down to the Amen pew, where sat Sister Bertha Better Than You, who'd been watching all the commotion with sadistic glee. Should have seen the look in her eyes when that squirrel jumped her garters and crossed her thighs, and she jumped to her feet and said, Lord, have mercy on me. As the squirrel made laps inside her dress, she began to cry and then to confess to sins that would make a sailor blush with shame. She told of gossip and church dissension, but the thing that got the most attention was when she talked about her love life, and then she started naming names. The day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, hallelujah. Well, seven deacons and the pastor got saved, and $25,000 got raised, and 50 volunteered for missions in the Congo on the spot. And even without an invitation, there were at least 500 rededications, and we all got rebaptized, whether we needed it or not. Now you've heard the Bible story, I guess, how he parted the waters for Moses to pass, all the miracles God has wrought in this old world. But the one I'll remember till my dying day is how he put that church back on the narrow way with a half-crazed Mississippi squirrel. Now, the day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula. It was a fight for survival that broke out in revival. They were jumping pews and shouting, hallelujah. And the day the squirrel went berserk in the First Self-Righteous Church in that sleepy little town of Pascagoula.
AM 750 WSB presents the Ludlow Porch Talk Show. If you would like to talk to Ludlow, dial 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Now, here's Ludlow Porch.
All right. 10 minutes after 12 o'clock. Listen, today is the 10th birthday of Marshall Peterson. So when you see Marshall, you tell him happy birthday. He's 10 years old today. Wide open, gang, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK. It is Monday and a beautiful one, and we're going to talk to Momo Looney. Hello there.
Oh.
How you doing?
I'm doing just great. How are you?
Doing good.
You look precious today, sweetie.
Well, thank you.
Now, Ludlow, I want to tell you that I feel like I have taught 135 children over the past years.
Uh-huh.
I had my own little child on February 14th. Smartest and brightest child ever born.
Yeah.
So I'm at home with him listening to Ludlow this year.
Well, good.
Well, I want to share some out of the mouth of babes with you.
Good.
I was working with a little child one day, cute little boy, big blue eyes, over in the corner. We gave him a little puzzle to do, and I said, wait a little while, and I went back, and I said, now, sweetie, why didn't you finish your little puzzle? And he looked at me with those big eyes, and he said, well, Mama, I surely couldn't finish because I've been sitting over here catching ghosts. Same child, walking down the hall one day from lunch, starts saying an ugly word. And this is a good school. Ugly word, Ludlow. Same word begins with the same letter as family and fun.
Uh-huh.
Well, I was appalled, you can imagine. So I went up to him and put my little arm around him. I said, now, sweetie, what word did you just say? He got right in my face with those eyes and proceeded to say that word about 14 times. Never ask a child what did they say.
Yeah, because they'll tell you.
That's exactly right.
They will tell you.
Last little story, and then I want to close with a little something. A little child came in school one morning and had this huge jewelry box. And she said, Mama Looney, look what Daddy brought me back. He's been on a trip. And I said, that is the most beautiful jewelry box I have ever seen. I said, what did he bring your sister? Well, he brought her a doll. And I said, well, that is nice. I said, well, did he bring your mother anything back? And she said, well, Daddy didn't bring her anything back that he told us. But he said he's going to give her a great big surprise tonight.
Never ask if you don't want to know.
That's exactly right. Ludlow, whatever you do today, you have yourself a nap, some cookies, and a tall glass of juice.
Talk to you soon.
All right. Bye-bye.
Let's talk to Billy on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Bill.
How you doing today, Ludlow?
Doing good, buddy.
You still talking about the favorite characters?
We're wide open. Whatever's on your mind is on our mind.
Greatest show to me ever put on TV, Andy Griffith, my two favorite, Ernest T. Bass and Barney Fife.
Two great ones.
Got to be the greatest.
You know, that's an unusual, that's almost a phenomenon, because I certainly agree with you about Barney, but I bet you if you and I tried to sit down and think about a single good quality that Barney Fife had, we'd be hard-pressed.
Exactly, except he's true American.
Well, no question about that, but that's, you know, but he's a coward, he's a liar, he's a braggart, and I just loved him.
I think everybody does.
And I don't know why, but I sure did.
It was a great, great character, great show.
Oh, yeah.
But talking about the youth, too, I've got a line of my little nephew. He's 5 years old. About a year ago, was riding along with me in the truck one day, and I had a candy cane. And he said, I want some. And I gave it to him and told him to break it in two. And when he did, naturally, the had a piece about 4 inches long and one about 1 inches, and about 1 inch. And I said, give me a piece. And I didn't tell him which one. And he stood there, and he rode along for about 5 minutes. And finally, he says, I'm going to give you this short one. I'm going to keep the big one. I need it so I can grow big like you. They can come up with it whenever they need it.
I guarantee you.
But Ludlow, have a good day, and I enjoyed it.
Bill, take care, buddy.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Joan, you're on AM 750 WSB. Hello, Joan.
This is John.
John, all right, I'll settle, John. How you doing?
I'm fine, Ludlow.
I'm sorry, John. I had you down as a Joan, and you don't sound like a Joan.
I hope my voice is a little deeper than that.
It is.
Ludlow, I wanted to call you. I'm on my way to Columbia, South Carolina. I've listened to you all morning.
Well, good.
And I heard you mention the show Evening Shade.
Mm-hmm.
And I just wanted to make a comment. I was very pleased to hear your positive comments about the show, since my nephew has just become affiliated with the show.
Oh, wonderful. Great.
He's a writer. And as a matter of fact, I don't know if you happened to see the episode the week before last where they were put in jail.
Yeah.
That was his show.
Well, what's his name?
Stephen A. Miller.
I'm going to watch for him. That's wonderful.
Yeah, he had just joined him, and he's looking forward to it, and as we are, obviously.
Well, I think he's going to have a nice long run with that show, because I really feel like that they got a winner on their hands, and I think he's going to move up in the ratings every week.
Well, I agree. I think it's building slowly. I think it's going to be, you know, something that's not an overnight hit, but I think it's going to build slowly and really come on strong.
I'm not sure there's ever been a television series where they spent that much money on supporting people.
Could very well be.
They got some great ones. Well, listen, congratulations on your nephew's success.
Thank you, Lolo. Good to talk to you, sir.
Take care, pal.
Right.
872-0750. I think Cecil is next. Hello, Cecil.
Enjoyed yourself. You were talking about one of my favorite characters. Can you hear me? I'm on a car phone.
Hear you fine, Cecil.
Okay. You were talking about one of my favorite shows, the Yancey Derringer.
Yeah.
And you mentioned the Indian Companion.
Yeah.
You know what his name was on the show?
Name was Pahu on the show.
Pahu Katiwa.
Yeah.
Okay, now what does that stand for in English, according to the show?
I think that means wolf who stands in water.
Man, you bad. You know that? Well, I bet you can't answer this one. What all did he carry up under that cloak?
They don't tell it.
There you go. You have that one. That's right. That's who we need over there in Iraq. Boy, he'd go over there and take care of business, wouldn't he?
He pulled out from under that coat whatever he needed.
Yes, he sure did. Okay, bud. I enjoy your show, so keep up the good work.
Come in there, Cecil. I'll talk to you, buddy.
Enjoying humor to everybody.
Thank you, buddy.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. 17 minutes after 12 o'clock at AM 750 WSB.
Here's what's happening this week on AM 750 WSB. Campbell's Chunky Soup and us invite you to bring your can to the Eagles-Falcons game on November 18th. Each canned good donation will be matched by Campbell's to help feed the hungry. The first 10,000 fans to bring a can will get an autographed Falcons bandana. I'm Garo McKee. Hope to see you there.
This is Wes Minter reminding you to listen to Atlanta's Morning Show and the Gary McKee Hometown Radio Show for your chance to win tickets to see the Atlanta Ballet's performance of Gershwin's By George on November 17th. And catch AM 750 WSB night at the Ballet Friday. Mention AM 750 WSB when you order your tickets and get 25% off. Tickets are available by calling Ticketmaster at 249-6400.
Join us at the Stouffer Waverly Hotel for Atlanta's Morning Show on Thursday for the Great American Smokeout. Kathy Fishman and I will be broadcasting live from 5 to 9. Come on by. There's lots of prizes, and we want to help you stop smoking. I'm Bobby Harper, and that's what's happening on AM 750 WSB.
There's a special kind of energy.
Residents of the Dunwoody Forest Apartments in Chamblee are serving our community with their special kind of energy with a resident recycling program. Residents are recycling glass, plastic, and aluminum. The money they earn from recycling is given to the Sheltering Arms Family Support Program, which provides needy children and families with affordable services to help them become self-sufficient. Georgia Power salutes the residents of the Dunwoody Forest Apartments for making our world a better place. If you know someone who is serving our environment with their energy, write to us in care of Georgia Power Salutes at AM 750 WSB.
Serving you with energy on the power of our pride.
You know po' folks keeps on cooking.
Atlanta's best fried chicken. Atlanta's favorite coleslaw.
Favorite biscuits, best iced tea.
Say when, Atlanta. Enjoy all you can eat of our classic home-style favorites. Just say when, and we'll bring you hearty portions of Atlanta's best fried chicken, country fried steak, Gulf shrimp, or southern-style catfish. Our all-you-can-eat dinners come with endless servings of home-style vegetables, over a dozen to choose from. Plus, right now, we'll even treat you to dessert. Our new home-style banana pudding is the perfect ending to Atlanta's best all-you-can-eat meal. We'll keep serving till you say when.
You know po' folks keeps on cooking.
Atlanta's best fried chicken. Atlanta's favorite coleslaw.
Favorite biscuits, best iced tea. Hope folks keeps on fixing. Heart at home style cooking. Smile, Atlanta, you're at Po-Folks.
Hearty home style, all you can eat. With free banana pudding. Only at Po-Folks.
We're here in the beautiful state of Washington for the final round of the Washington Apple Pro-Am. The surprise leader, Fuzzy Clamper, is about to attempt the putt that could bring him his first major tournament win.
Could you hold it down, please? This is pretty important to me.
Oh, sorry. Fuzzy Clamper, understandably nervous.
Please, would you?
Oh, sorry. About to putt for the $100,000 first prize in the Washington Apple Pro-Am. And the distinctive red apple blazer signifying the victor of the Washington Apple Pro-Am.
Look, I'm not going to putt until you shut up.
I'm sorry, Fuzzy. Excuse me.
Ah, for gosh sakes, what bozo bit the apple?
Not just an apple, Fuzzy, a crisp, crunchy Washington State apple.
I don't care what kind of apple it was. Look, if you apple knockers just hold it down for a second, I'd appreciate it.
Well, sorry. No. Showing traditional Washington courtesy, the gallery is hushed as Fuzzy attempts to putt for the tie.
Okay, you can keep the blazer. I didn't want it. Get the apples. Get
Washington apples. They're as good as you've heard.
All right, 12:22 now at AM 750 WSB. Right back to the phones. Talk to John. John, how you doing? John?
Yes, I'm here.
How you doing, bud?
Hi, I'm fine. How you doing?
Good, thank you.
Listen, I really enjoyed your squirrel song. I really got a kick out of that. Who's the artist of that song?
Ray Stevens.
Who?
Ray Stevens.
Oh, okay. That was really neat. I just happened to turn on the radio and just took me pee.
Well, good. I'm glad.
All right. Have a nice day.
Okay. Thank you, John. Bye-bye. And the real Sarah is with us. Miss Sarah, how you doing?
Hello, my dear.
You behaving yourself?
Yeah, that's asking much too much.
Okay.
I get you on this every year. Who is Marie Ann Smith?
Yeah, you sure do. Looks like I have enough sense to remember that, doesn't it?
I know.
Who?
That's Granny Smith.
Okay, that's
right. That developed the apple. She's an old maid. 1839.
That's right. But I tell you what she did. She came up with a great apple.
She sure did. I bet she died a rich old biddy, too.
I hope so.
At the price of those suckers.
I hope so.
You know, there's some man that I keep seeing in movies and on TV, and I've never heard him mentioned, and he absolutely convulses me. I know his first name is Richard, and he plays this sleazy lawyer as a rule. That smirky face, and he's always in his britches too deep. He just goes on so. I seem to think of Lord as the last name, Richard Lord, Mr. but that Lord. Doesn't.
I will watch for him. Is he a regular in anything or just kind
no.
of?
No, uh-uh. Okay. He's strictly a bit player, but when he comes on, I convulse.
I'll watch for him.
And the funniest thing that has ever been on television was when Flo wrecked Mel's car. Did you remember that episode?
It's from Alice.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
Where's this car? It's between 16th and 17th on 3rd. Remember where the little pottery stand used to be? And there she stands with that white cap thing cockeyed on her head. You know, that was the funniest thing to me.
I do remember.
Mary Tyler Moore went to Tutu the Clown's funeral.
Oh, that's... That was so
classic.
Funny. I kept that.
Oh, that's so funny.
I kept
funny.
That, yeah.
Well, let me brag about, not out of the mouths of babes, but it's my babe. Dear Ann, yesterday on M7 in the paper, a man from Savannah had written and said that he got a letter that everybody should read and post it on their dashboard. And it was sent him by Paramedics Against Drunken Drivers.
Uh-huh.
Well, it should be Paramedics Against Intoxicated Drivers, PAID.
Uh-huh.
You know, my son founded that organization and is now president of it.
I know it, and he works harder at that than anybody on earth.
You better believe it. And the letter itself is what they send out. I think he composed it. He knows it by heart anyway.
Yeah.
But I thought that was nice, and they operate on a shoestring and do a beautiful job. I've got two ambulances in my backyard and one in my neighbor's yard across the street right this minute. 6-foot skeleton laying in one of them, and a 6-foot mannequin laying in the other.
And he is.
And a buzzard that says, "I've seen you down there without your seatbelt on." He's got cute props, and they do work hard. They go to Tennessee, Florida. You know, he got a national citation for that. And they flew him to Boston and had a banquet and all that. But it's sort of low key. Of course, they've been to that something Pratt Manufacturing Company in Columbus and made a presentation in front of the employees there. Lots of different companies. Pratt Whitney.
A hardworking, civic-minded young man. I know you're proud of him.
The boys are really sincere, the whole crowd.
Yeah.
Well, thank
you. Listen, why don't you send me something I can get in our PSA, because they are operating on a shoestring, and they might could...
They really are. His piggy bank is flat.
send me something that we can work on.
I'll be happy to.
All right, my
thank
friend.
Thank you much.
Take care, sir. Bye-bye. Let's talk to Gilmer quickly on AM 750 WSB.
Yeah, Laura, I just wonder if you remember an old Western radio show called Straight Arrow. It was like the opposite of the Lone Ranger.
Yes, I do.
An Indian was the hero, and he had an old white man named Packy for a sidekick.
That's right.
He was adopted by a white family and grew up as Steve Adams, and then he found this prophecy in a cave somewhere in a costume about some character named Straight Arrow. So he assumed that role.
Yeah.
I've always wondered how come they didn't make a movie or a TV show out of that Straight Arrow. It was a...
You know, I don't know.
Two episodes of it on an LP record, and they are fantastic.
Didn't Jim Amici, Don Amici's brother, do the voice of Straight Arrow?
I believe so. I don't have my big broadcast book handy with me right now, but that does sound like a familiar name there.
I think Jim Amici was the voice of Straight Arrow, and as a child, Straight Arrow was one of my heroes, and I don't know why. He never made it into television, never made it into the movies, and I don't know why.
But it was a great show, really. It was just as good as the Lone Ranger show was.
Oh, I think so. I think so. Glad you called, buddy.
Okay, Ludlow. Good to hear from you there.
Talk to you. So we talked to your mother a little earlier.
Yeah, I heard a while ago. We're talking there. I don't know if you ever seen that Get a Life last night on TV.
No, I didn't.
That was a funny show. Old Chris learning how to drive for the first time. He's 30 years old and still hasn't got a driver's license yet.
Oh.
It's a crazy show.
I didn't see it. I didn't see it.
Yeah, it's so crazy. That's why I like it.
Hang in there.
Okay.
Talk to you later.
Okay, bye.
Bye-bye. Our number, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK.
And a minister who preaches while wearing pumps.
Even though I am a transsexual, I am at heart basically a Pentecostal person.
Tune in. It's Gary.
Bye.
Wonderful weekdays on AM 750 WSB, Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic leader. It is 12:30, and with a quick update, here's Bob Cox.
Good. It's time for fun and interesting conversation with Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB. The lines are open for you at 872-0750. That's 872-0750. Here's Ludlow Porch.
All right. It is 12:33 now. Gorgeous day. Picture book. Could be up into the 70s today. Delightful. Let's get back to the phones now. We have an open line. What's on your mind? We'll talk to you about it. And here is Jim. How you doing, Jim?
Hello, Jim. Jim from Marietta.
Yes, sir.
I read a sad story in Friday's paper about William Andrews. Did you happen to read that?
No, I heard about it, but I didn't see a paper.
The man happens to be $1 million or something like that in debt.
Yeah.
And, you know, for all the things he's done for us, not only with his playing, but I have never heard a negative word about this man. He just seems like a prince of a peer's person.
Yeah, apparently you're right.
Is there some way, and I'll do this myself if I knew how to do it, is there some way we can start a fund and get people to send in just $1 to help bail this man out?
Sure, there are ways to do that. I'm not sure legally how you start it, but...
See, if I were to go to a bank and say, let's start a fund for William Andrews, why, they'd look at me like I had malaria.
Maybe not. Maybe not. Try it.
Think it would work?
Couldn't hurt.
I just think we owe him something, don't you?
No.
You don't?
No, I admire him. I admire him, and I would help with any fund you put together, but I don't think I owe him anything.
Oh. I just think he's done so much for the city.
I think he has, too, and I admire him greatly. I'm a fan of his, and I would contribute to anything you put together and help any way I could. But I don't think I owe him anything.
Well, that's admiration. I'll settle for that.
Okay, partner.
Listen,
if you do it, sure enough, I'll be glad to help any way I can. Let me know.
I'll start at the local bank.
Hang in, my friend.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. 872-0750. Bob is on the line. Hello, Bob.
Good morning, Ludlow.
How are you, old friend?
All right, over in Morgan County.
Yes, sir.
What's going on with you today?
I don't know it. I don't know. What part of the county are you in? You in Madison?
Yeah, between Madison and Rutley.
All right.
The fellow talking about owing William Andrews, I think they paid him when he worked, didn't they?
Uh-huh. He's a good guy.
Wrong. That ain't our fault.
He's a good guy, and I'll help him if I can.
Yeah, that's the way I feel.
Yeah.
I was on the way to Jacksonville Friday, and I was hearing about every fifth word down between Dublin and Hazelhurst. My wife finally said, won't you turn this station on something we can pick up? And somebody was talking about China bears and fleas. And what were they talking about?
Well, somebody said that when they were little and they had, when they got fleas under the house, that their mama would have them break off China berry limbs and put under the house, that would run fleas out.
The limbs themselves do the best.
Well, I guess the limbs with berries on them.
I see.
And you know what? We just dang near lost all our China berry trees. We had a blight come through here a few years back.
No, I know where there's a few around here.
Yeah, they're coming back, but they used to be everywhere.
Right.
But I don't know whether they run fleas off or not.
I just wonder. I got a few fleas in my yard, so I might try it out.
Couldn't hurt.
But I couldn't hear what he was saying to do. I was so far away.
Yeah, that's what he was talking about.
All right. Somebody was talking about going to come see you Monday, too, over there. Was it Luther talking about coming to see you?
Where was that?
On the radio Friday. They were going to come see you this week, and you told him Monday would be the best day, and you ain't even there.
I think I might have been pulling Luther's leg, wasn't
I don't
you?
Know if it was Luther or somebody else. Now, I don't know.
No, it was Luther.
Was it Luther?
It was Luther, yeah.
I thought it was, yeah.
You take care of yourself,
Bob. I got two more things, one quick one I'm going to ask you.
Okay, bud.
I got a net by it. Y'all just advertised that sky copter and sky plane.
Yeah.
I ain't never heard of a ground copter and a ground plane.
And we got some of those, too, yeah.
You got some of them, too. All right, and I got a trivia thing for you that I heard on WSB back in the days when they had the Whiz Kids on.
All right. Yeah, oh, yeah.
All right, they asked something that a sentence that you can say, but you can't write down.
Yep.
Remember that?
Yeah, there are three twos in the English language.
That's right.
Yeah.
Now, did they ever figure out a way to write it down?
I don't think you can.
Well, they were talking about it at that time, trying to get the word T-O-O-Z in the dictionary. cover that?
As far as I know, they hadn't made it.
Uh-huh. Okay. Now, did anybody say they like Zorro?
Oh, I did, yeah. Zorro, one of my very favorites.
All right, mine too.
One of my very favorites,
mine
yeah.
Too. All right. Well, we went to the ball game and left at halftime.
Came on home, did you?
Ate a lot of seafood and enjoyed the trip.
Well.
I expected to get beat by 30 points when I left, so I wasn't disappointed.
No, you wasn't. Bob, take care of yourself.
All right, Lalo, thank you.
Talk to you
bye-bye.
Soon. Rand, you're on AM 750 WSB.
Hello there, Southwest Ledlow.
Hello, Rand.
I haven't talked to you in a while there. Sorry about that.
Well, we're glad to have you back. What's on your mind?
I was eating breakfast this morning, and I was listening to your show, you know, early this morning, and you was talking about wrestling, about Andre the Giant, where he beat up some guy that was took his film picture of him?
Yeah, a television cameraman, I think, yeah.
Yeah, I didn't hear nothing about that. You know, I watched a lot of wrestling, and I didn't hear nothing about that. About 3 or 4 years ago, a couple of them, they got another wrestler just came into the Atlanta area. He's bigger than Andre. Andre's 7'4".
Yeah.
They got a guy that wrestles now. He's 7'7". I hate to run into a dark alley against him, wouldn't you?
Or in the middle of a cornfield. Sound like a big man. Rand, take care of yourself, buddy. I'll talk to you soon. Glad you called. Let's talk to the one and only Doris. How you doing?
Hi.
How's it going?
I'm just going fine.
Good.
Listen, I want to tell you something.
All right.
You have upset me this morning.
Doris.
You have destroyed one of my long, long persons that I love to watch on the TV.
What did I do, Doris?
The Lone Ranger.
Uh-huh.
I never thought about him being a sissy.
Uh-huh.
And now I'll never be able to look at him again without thinking about what you'd say.
Well, it's true, and you know it's true, Doris.
Well, I know. After you said it, and I thought about it, I thought, well, why didn't I say that? I couldn't believe it.
That's right.
Why did you do that?
Well, I just thought that I needed to enlighten you some.
Well, you did. And how in the world are you doing?
I'm doing good. You all right?
I'm doing fine.
Good. Did you have a pleasant week?
Huh?
Pleasant weekend?
I did. I went to Helen Saturday.
All right.
And there wasn't hardly nobody up there, though.
Really? Well, you know why, don't you? Because they all went the last two weekends.
Oh, did they?
Yeah.
I sure am glad.
Yeah, I know what you mean.
The Lees was beautiful.
Because Helen can be crowded as a Southeastern fair, if you ain't there.
I know it. I've been up there before when it was, but
yeah.
It's real pretty.
Yeah.
And where was you signing books at yesterday?
Yesterday, I was on Johnson Ferry Road in the Walden bookstore yesterday.
Well, do you ever come on the south side of town?
Yeah, I was in, my wife and I were in Bookland in Fayetteville Saturday.
Well, I wished I hadn't, but I couldn't have done any good. I've been telling.
Well, you could have canceled that trip.
Well, no, I don't.
We're coming back. We're going to be back in Fayetteville.
Oh, are you going?
Yeah. I don't have my schedule with, but I'll let you know.
Oh, you will?
Yeah.
Okay, because I would like to come out and see you.
I'd love that.
I know that's right. Will you have your wife with you?
Oh, yeah. She co-wrote the book.
Oh, did she?
Yeah.
Well, what's the name of it?
The Fat White Guy's Cookbook.
Gosh, that's terrible. Oh, that's terrible. Well, let me ask you something, ma'am.
Okay.
The other day when I called, this man answered the phone. Do you know who it might have been?
You mean the producer?
Well, I don't know. He answered the phone, and I was trying to tell him that you said for me to give my name as My Doris, and he thought that was one word. Then he had to make me spell it. And I said, you're not from the South, are you?
Oh, Gary McDowell. Yeah.
Is he cute as he sounds?
Yeah, he's cute as a button, yeah. You
but
love
him. He must not be from the South, is he?
And he ain't cute as a Lone Ranger.
Oh. I will never be able to look at him again without thinking about you talking about them white skinny britches and...
Well, I want you to notice next time and ask yourself this question. Why did he wear a mask?
Well, I don't know, and I ain't figured out them breeches now that you mentioned. All those years, I just looked at him and liked him, and now all at once, I've got different thoughts about him.
You take care of yourself, Doris.
I will.
I'll talk to you soon.
Okay,
bye. Bye-bye. 18 minutes before 1 o'clock at AM 750 WSB.
Hi, this is Bobby Harper for OptiWorld. You know, eyeglass lenses are primarily designed to correct your vision. But now new technology not only makes you see better, but also makes you look better. You see, OptiWorld has all the latest innovations, including progressive or no-line bifocals. Let's talk for a second about bifocals, and let's talk for a second just to the folks over the age of 40, because after 40, the ability of the eye to focus up close starts to decline. Well, progressive lenses not only protect your vanity, they also provide vision correction in a graduated range. The lower portion of the lens corrects for reading, the middle for arm's length distance, and the top for far away. And there's no irritating line or visual jump when you look up and down. And remember, OptiWorld guarantees that your lenses will be ready when promised, or they're free. And the 90-day no-questions-asked guarantee ensures your complete guarantee and satisfaction. OptiWorld, the friendly eye care superstore.
Surprise, it's Mervyn's store-wide clearance. But that's not the surprise. The real surprise is what Mervyn's is clearing out. You can save 40 to 60% on clearance items throughout the store. But you never know what great things you can save on. It's just, surprise, save 40% on this? Ooh. And surprise, 60% off that? Wow. Mervyn's store-wide clearance is going on now. So come in soon, or surprise, it'll be over.
Good morning, Mrs. Klatzenmeyer. Time for your regular Jiffy Lube oil and filter change and complete 14-point service.
Hmm? Yep. Got your 3,000-mile reminder. And don't forget the world-class protection of Pennzoil.
Well, that's what makes Jiffy Lube number one, you know. Say, where's Mr. K, Mrs. K?
I just left him at the emergency room.
Oh, no. An accident?
Nope. A lesson.
A lesson?
He says, Hazel, I'm going to teach you how to change your own oil. Save some money.
Uh-oh.
Took two paramedics and a wrecker to get him out after the jack slipped. Got third-degree burns from the exhaust pipe. And they pumped about 2 quarts of oil out of his stomach.
Sounds pretty nasty.
Yep, wasn't even Pennzoil.
Well, you know, at Jiffy Lube, we always use Pennzoil to protect your engine and your car's warranty. Tell me, when will Mr. K be out of the hospital?
Doc says in about $2,600.
Jiffy Lube also offers you free fluid top-offs between services. Visit any of our 27 convenient locations. At Jiffy Lube, we do your car a great service.
Our reporters cover the news wherever it happens, in town and in the suburbs. Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
All right, 872-0750, 1-800-WSB-TALK, Ludlow Ports, holding forth, waiting breathlessly for Wes Minter to make his appearance in about 15 minutes. You stick around and enjoy the Wes Minter Show, 1 to 4 weekdays on AM 750 WSB. Back to the phones, and we're going to talk to Snellville. Hello there.
Snelldoodle Dandy, hey. You cut me off before I gave the full name.
Well, I should have known. That's my fault. How you doing?
I'm fine. I haven't talked with you in a while.
This is your day, isn't it?
Well, yes, and it's rather quiet because there's nothing to do today. It was all done Saturday and yesterday.
Yeah, yeah.
But it was a busy weekend and a long weekend, and we enjoyed it very much. Man, it was cold downtown Saturday at that parade.
Was it cold?
Whoa. I was down on the reviewing stand, and I know, I've been on aircraft carriers before, and I know that wind had to be going 60 knots, and it was about 35, 40 degrees.
It'll pick up right nice when the wind's blowing like that.
Yeah. But it was a nice weekend. Had a biggest parade we've ever had.
Well, that's super.
The crowd was slim because of the weather, but it was a big parade.
Yeah, we had all that bad weather Friday night, and I thought to myself, I hope this goes away for that parade, because there wouldn't be enough folks downtown to get up together a good checker game with that kind of rain we had.
Went to a little monument dedication yesterday in Lawrenceville, and got a report from the Blue Ribbon Bird Dog there. Yeah. Timberlake boy.
Oh yeah, we stood shoulder to shoulder.
Had a good time Saturday.
Yeah, had a big time. I think he had more fun than I did, but he usually does.
he's good at a party.
No question.
No doubt about it.
No question.
I'm a little bit disillusioned. I thought perhaps you could give me some direction.
All right.
All the talk and everyone had prior to the election. I say this because I know you don't like talking politics right after election, but I thought maybe enough time had gone by now we could discuss it a little bit.
Yeah.
What happened to all the kick the incumbents out and get rid of the bumps?
It just didn't happen, did it?
I guess every incumbent's bad except your own.
That's right. It's the other guy. Because, you know, I was all come back. And the first thing they do is attack the Congress.
Yeah, you know, I can understand it to a degree, because when I went in the booth and it was, you know, I said, do I really want to vote against it? I'm going to do it. And I did it, and I can understand why people didn't do it.
Yeah.
And, man, they just continue to spend our money, our tax money, and I just don't understand it. So where do we go from here is my question.
Well, as I've said before, and I hope you know, I'm a very positive person. But I think I don't think there's anything to be positive about. I think from the economic standpoint, we're doomed. I think it's going to be a fiscal collapse someday, and I'm not sure how far down the road we can handle this. But I do know that there's no interest at all in balancing the budget. The people are not interested in it, and Congress is certainly not interested in it. They are interested in having higher taxes. And while we're not all together shoulder to shoulder pouring tea in a harbor somewhere is beyond me.
Well, you know, and I talked to a lot of people prior to the election. I mean, a lot of people. I'm not voting for any incumbent. And it was just, you know, and I don't know what happened. I thought it was really out there. I really and honestly, truly honestly thought it was out there.
A lot of people did, including me.
And it may be just the beginning. That's the only hope or salvation that I may have. You know, it might be just the beginning of it. Maybe next time, who knows?
I would like to think so, but I doubt it.
But, you know, when people like Bernard and Jenkins go back in with 60 or 70% of the vote, I just don't understand it. What do you think is going to happen with the reapportionment as far as Gwinnett's concerned, as far as the new congressional seat? Do you think they're going to split it up like as they did before, as it is now, or do you think they might, the governor and the good old boys downtown might just concede Gwinnett and give us our own congressman?
I don't know. It's hard to tell. Because you got a new crowd coming in there downtown, you know.
So we'll see. Nice. And maybe all we can do is hope and pray that the people will reconsider next election. And, you know, I am so tired of the tax money just going and going and going. I don't know what else to say, let alone.
You take care of your bad self.
It's been a pleasure. It's a pretty day to fly the flag.
Hang in there. Go do it. I'll talk to you.
Bye.
Bye-bye. It is 10 minutes before 1 o'clock. Here's our own meteorologist, Kirk Mellish.
Every corner of the state just beautiful for today, Ludlow, and the same thing for tomorrow. Plenty of sunshine, highs in the 60s and 70s, lows in the 30s and 40s. With frequent weather updates, I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
I like the way you make me laugh. I like the funny things you do. You got a style that's on your own. I like the pride in you. You make me wanna smile. You know you make me sparkle too. You're such a kid to have around. I like the pride in you. I like the pride in you. I like the pride in you.
I'd hate for anybody to have to go back what we've been through.
A car crash can mean big cash at the local body shop.
How much did you pay for this repair?
$3,200.
I'm Channel 2's consumer reporter, B.D. Emmerman. What are your chances of getting a first-rate body repair job locally? And what about insurance restrictions? Can they really tell you where to get your car fixed?
I'm pretty surprised that they would actually let me go out of there with an unsafe car.
If you want to protect your family's safety and your investment in your car, watch this special assignment.
Take it for a ride. A special assignment tonight at 6 on Channel 2 Action News. How private are your cellular phone conversations?
People are listening, and they can listen freely. The privacy does not exist.
I'm Channel 2 News reporter Tom Regan. Before you say another word on your cellular phone, think about this. Who's listening? I'll tell you some things you need to know.
Rather than suspecting that it's possible that someone might be listening, it's far nearer the truth to assume that someone is listening.
Cellular Spies, tomorrow at 6 on Channel 2's Action News, George's News Team.
Directory assistance, may I help you?
Yeah, my little girl broke out in hives. My polka dot princess needs a doctor.
Probably a dermatologist. You know, I'd call MedCall.
And my husband, the triathlon man, hurt his poor knee taking out the garbage.
Oh, you can get an orthopedist through MedCall.
Wait, I'm not through. My teenager's grades are slipping. He's either in love or he needs glasses.
Call MedCall.
No matter what kind of specialist you're looking for, MedCall is the only physician referral service that covers the whole metro area. They can match you up with hundreds of doctors in over 40 specialized fields for free.
So, what's MedCall's phone number?
The number's the same as their name, MEDCALL, or 633-2255.
thanks.
You know, you don't sound too good. Could you be coming down with the flu?
Med call.
Find the doctor who treats you well. Call M-E-D-C-A-L-L.
Hey, did you hear that Bob bought Sandy a big diamond?
No, that cheap son of a... Wait a minute. Where did he buy it?
At the Golden Diamond Source, of course.
When economy-minded people look for a value, they go to the source. The Golden Diamond Source. Because when you buy from the source, you skip the fat cat wholesaler's profits, which means you get more and pay less for it. And that is exactly what happens when you buy from the Golden Diamond Source. You skip the fat cat wholesaler's profits. You get a larger, better quality diamond at the Golden Diamond Source and pay less for it. I know, because I'm Steve Weintraub, president of the Golden Diamond Source, and we guarantee it. The Golden Diamond Source guarantees the finest quality diamonds at the lowest price or your money refunded. So take a tip from Bob.
Is this where Bob bought his diamond?
It sure is.
Buy your diamond with confidence from the jeweler you have grown to trust. The Golden Diamond Source, your original diamond broker.
The Golden Diamond Source on Roswell Road at the corner of Hammond Drive just north of the perimeter. And next to Cub Foods on Jimmy Carter Boulevard just east of I-85.
Join us, Gary McKee, in the Hometown Radio Show this afternoon, 4 to 7. In your guts, you know we're nuts. Now more of Ludlow Porch on AM 750 WSB.
All right. What a day. What a day. Let's get right back to our phones and talk to my buddy, the ghost of East Point. Hello, old friend.
How you doing?
How you doing?
Heroes that never existed?
Yeah.
Captain Nemo.
Okay. Nemo, one of your heroes?
At a very young age, I was exposed to Jules Verne, and I read all of his books. And I would nominate all of his heroes, like Journey into the Center of the Earth, James Mason, play the guy, I can't think of what he was. And that fascinated me. You know, Jules Verne was the first science fiction writer.
Yes.
Okay. Two other quick subjects.
All right.
You got any tomatoes left?
No, gone.
I've got two vines outside of my house, 8 feet tall, and I got some tomatoes on them the size of a ping pong ball.
Oh, they're not getting ripe, are they?
I don't think they are.
No.
I'm gonna bronze them and put them on my mantelpiece.
Good for you.
One other subject.
All right.
A week or so ago, you were talking about Fred Waring. You belittled him a little bit.
No, I didn't.
Not too much, but I don't read obits too much, but there is an obit in today's General Constitution that Everett Mitchell died Friday at Wheaton, Illinois. Does Everett Mitchell strike a chord?
No.
He was the announcer on the National Farm and Home Hour that came on at 11:30 on WSB in the 1930s, and his classic line always was, wherever there was 6 inches of snow in the Windy City, he said, "It's a beautiful day in Chicago."
I'll be darned. Yeah, I remember that catch line.
Okay,
yeah.
He was 92 years old. He died at a convalescent home Friday in Wheaton, Illinois.
I'll be darned.
Have a good week.
Take care, buddy.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Sue Ann, you're on AM 750 WSB.
I wish I was where you is.
How you doing?
I'm fine, thank you.
Good. It's Sue Ann today, is it?
Yes. Sue Ann Marshall today.
Uh-huh. Very...
I'm losing it. You know, I can't find these names.
Very creative. You're doing fine.
Bloody.
Yeah.
I was in and out of the car this morning, and I heard you start with fictitious or people you wish you could meet.
Your favorite character that never lived.
Ah. Uh-huh. Maximilian de Winter.
Max de Winter. Yes.
Max de Winter.
Yes. If your name was Rebecca, you wouldn't be anxious to meet him.
My name is Rebecca. Listen, the reason I called, okay?
Yes.
Are we ever going to get to see Joe, our $4 million man, play locally in this town? I mean, this guy has been blocked out with the most asinine football, and Bobby Harper, Bundy, all right?
Yeah.
He gives the scores twice. He mentions every score in the country, doesn't say anything about the 49ers.
He didn't mention the 49ers.
Not once. And so Van Note, this morning,
yeah.
Boom, right out of the box, you know. Tell Harper to tell what Joe does.
They won, but they always win.
Well, I hope so.
Yeah.
That's my team.
They're never going to lose again.
All right, now, do you have any idea, are we going to be able to see him play the Giants?
I don't know.
Locally?
I don't know.
it's a bore. I mean, it's a bore.
Well, but who knows? We might. There's no shortage of Montana on television.
You could there certainly is.
You haven't seen him this year?
Well, when he played Atlanta. Jeez, come on.
Are you telling me that that's the only time he's been on television?
Well,
this year?
It was on Monday night something, thank God. Yeah. I don't know, and twice was, but he should be on the air in Atlanta every single week.
Okay, I'll make a note of that.
Thank you.
Take care, you
and
sweet
Sam Harper, not to forget,
I will
tell what the score was.
I will tell Harper that you are listening every breath.
Every breath.
Take care of your sweet self. Talk to you. Need to get out of here now and make room for Wes Minner, who is coming down the hall with a great show put together for you. I will be right back with you tomorrow, and in the meantime, I want you to do me a favor. Whatever else you do today, you find somebody to be nice to.
Only station that covers traffic with our own helicopter and airplane. AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
WSB Atlanta.
News time at the tone, 1 o'clock.
Good afternoon. I'm Bob Cox in the AM 750 WSB News Center. The temperature at 1 o'clock, a sunny 66 degrees. Today's weather, sunny, warm, low humidity, high of 71. From a Bell South Mobility caller, some guy's riding a bicycle against traffic in the breakdown lane in the outside ring of 285 near Riverside Drive, so bear that in mind. 36-year-old Sergeant Ricky Baggett of the Winder Police Force may owe his life to the bulletproof vest he was wearing when he stopped a car on Georgia 81 just before 10:30 this morning. A man and a woman were fighting inside the car. As Sergeant Baggett approached, several bullets slammed into his chest and arm. He was taken to the hospital. Luckily, suffered only a gunshot wound to the arm because the vest protected him. Meanwhile, police are looking for a blue or gray older model Dodge that took off south on Georgia 81 after the shooting. Crisis in the Gulf update. China's foreign minister is briefing Saudi leaders on his meetings with Iraqi leaders in Baghdad earlier today. One of the things they talked about is a call from Morocco for an Arab summit to try to keep the Gulf crisis from turning into a war. Meanwhile, the foreign ministers of the 12-nation European community are calling for all Western hostages in Iraq and Kuwait to be set free. Some in Congress, including Georgia's Sam Nunn, have raised questions about the size and speed of our military buildup in the Gulf and the momentum toward war. Dick Uliano reports from Los Angeles on a letter some Catholic leaders have sent President Bush.
The U.S. Conference of Bishops has endorsed the letter sent by Los Angeles Archbishop Roger Mahoney to Secretary of State Baker. Mahoney says the letter asks the administration to weigh the ethics of launching war in the Persian Gulf.
The letter basically calls the administration to look very carefully and cautiously at what would go into a decision to use force in the Persian Gulf.
Mahoney chairs the Bishop's International Policy Committee. The bishops have also decided to discuss in executive session amendments that might toughen the content of Mahoney's letter since it was sent before President Bush announced the latest troop buildup in the Persian Gulf. Dick Uliano at the Catholic Bishops Conference, Washington.
AM 750 WSB's international relations expert says the Bush administration's lack of a specific policy in the Persian Gulf could have disastrous results. Georgia Tech's Patrick O'Heffernan calls it an evolving strategy.
You can get into a war slowly, step by step, and each step looks rational. It was a good idea at the time, but the whole line of those steps can lead to the loss of 30 or 40,000 American lives. Without a clear idea of why we're losing those lives.
O'Heffernan says the national debate over why we're in the Gulf and what we hope to accomplish there is just starting, with Congress indicating it will take a more active role in setting policy. AM 750 WSB News Center time, 1:02, just ahead, what oil prices are doing, plus the weather from Atlanta's only full-time radio meteorologist.
Claude Akins for AMCO Transmissions.
If your car develops transmission trouble and you've got an extended warranty, do you have to go back to your dealer to get the work done?
Most people would say yes, but I've got news for you. You've probably got a choice. Your Amco Center honors most extended warranties, new cars and used cars. So if your transmission is making funny noises, if you spot a telltale leak, or if the gears are slipping, take your car to the people trained and equipped to perform that extended warranty service. Amco Center's mechanics will give your car's transmission the most complete diagnostic checkup in the industry. And with over 720 Amco Centers coast to coast, prompt expert service is never far away. Make sure you get the best service your extended warranty entitles you to. Bring your car's transmission to Amco.
Amco, AAMCO.
Your local independently owned and operated Amco Center can honor most extended service contracts. See your local white or yellow pages for the dealer nearest you. Open Saturdays.
Oh, meals can be a dream when you are serving the ones that are so lean. For morning, noon, and night, the taste is also right. Make your meals a dream.
Dubuque Supreme. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da.
Taste the supreme difference. Dubuque Supreme hams, franks, and bacon. So supremely lean, so truly satisfying, and so full of rich, hearty flavor.
Dubuque Supreme.
So remember, when meats are this lean and taste this savory and delicious, they're more than good. They're supreme.
Dubuque Supreme. Ya-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Dubuque Supreme.
And if it's Dubuque Plumpers you're looking for, they're available at the following supermarkets: Big Star, Cub Foods, Kroger, and your independent Super Value store. AM 750 WSB News Center Time 104. Tomorrow, the state Supreme Court hears arguments in a couple of high-profile cases, one involving the death of a little girl, the other involving the recent shooting spree at Perimeter Mall. In the first case, Cobb County prosecutors argue a murder charge against 28-year-old David Cross should be reinstated. His baby daughter died in 1988 after being beaten and shaken. His lawyer argued too much time elapsed between the time she was hurt and the time she died. The judge agreed, and a murder charge was dismissed. In the second case, the Southeastern Legal Foundation seeks release of the confidential medical records of James Calvin Brady, charged in the April shoot-up at the food court at Perimeter Mall. Oil prices are down more than $3 a barrel as traders decide the world has plenty of crude on hand and that war in the Persian Gulf does not seem imminent. And at last report on Wall Street, the Dow is up more than 40 points to 25.28¾. A highway crew in Southington, Connecticut, was using one of those high-velocity vacuum hoses to pick up leaves over the weekend when the machine accidentally sucked up a little orange and white cat. The cat survived, but a worker says it emerged from the other end with its fur standing straight up, which is understandable. The time, 1:05. Here, triple the traffic coverage. The Bell South Mobility Network and Skycopter Skyplane reports. And when you see a problem, dial asterisk 750, a free call for Bell South Mobility customers. Now, Atlanta's most accurate weather with WSB meteorologist Kirk Mellish.
Chance of rain is slim the next 7 days. The WSB exclusive forecast for this afternoon, blue sky and warm with low humidity, high 68 to 72. Clear and cool tonight, lows around 38. Tomorrow, sunshine and a bit cooler, high 65, low near 40. And the extended forecast, Wednesday through Friday, mainly sunny, high 65 to 70, lows 35 to 42. I'm meteorologist Kirk Mellish in the AM 750 WSB Weather Center.
Currently, WSB color radar is all clear. Clear, sunny skies, relative humidity 45%, winds from the west at 12, barometer 30.28 and falling. And at 106, the temperature on Peachtree Street, 67 degrees. WSB talk show host Wes Minter is next. I'm Bob Cox, and if news breaks out, we'll break in. This is Atlanta's news, weather, and traffic station, AM 750 WSB. Depend on it.
Don't tell me. You're from outer space.
No, I'm from Iowa. I only work in outer space.